Kyrie Sane has returned to the WWE. What does it mean for the SmackDown Women's Division? Let's get into it.
Keep up.
At Crown Jewel, Kyrie Sane returned to help Io Sky retain her title against Bianca Belair. Plenty of people within the IWC saw this coming, so good for you. Let's talk about how they brought her back. Before the Bianca Belair and Io Sky title match, Bianca cut a promo, and at this point, it was obvious to anyone with a brain that Bianca was going to lose. See, when you book one of the competitors to have a promo right before the PLE match, you are telling your audience that this is what I like to call a storytelling match or a storyline match. It's when the result of the match is pretty much known, but the goal here is to start or continue a story. For example, when Kevin Owens took on Roman Reigns at the Royal Rumble, we all knew that Kevin Owens was going to lose, but everyone was excited to see the match because we were interested in the post-match with Sami Zayn. The in-ring wasn't that important. We knew how the match would end, but we were interested in the story. So yeah, the Bianca Io match was there just to advance a story. So during this promo, Bianca says that she was happy that it was going to be her and Io 101 with no interference. And at that point, we knew she was going to lose. The only reason you have her say that is if she's going to be surprised because there will be interference. So yeah, before the match even started, we knew the result. Bianca thought she had taken Bayley out the night before so she wouldn't be able to travel, but clearly she was wrong because Bayley was there. So Bayley shows up and gets the ref's attention. Bianca gets the visual pin on Io, so technically she won, but the ref wasn't paying attention. Bianca goes to give Bayley a KOD on the outside, and that is when Kyrie Sane returns. She pulled Bayley off of Bianca, and Bianca is just flabbergasted. I guess because the last time Kyrie Sane was there in the WWE, she was a face, so Bianca didn't know how to react, I guess. Kyrie hits Bianca in the throat, then she jumps off the barricade and hits Bianca into the ring post. Bianca rolls into the ring, right in position for a moonsault from Io. She goes for the pin, Bianca loses, Io retains. Now, I don't love the way this match was produced in the end. I thought Kyrie's return could have been cooler, and it kind of made Bianca look like a goof, but whatever. So Io and Kyrie beat up Bianca. Kyrie goes for her beautiful elbow. She lands it, and Bayley is shocked. She had no idea Kyrie would be there, but Io was not surprised. Silly me, this whole time I thought Bayley would be the one to turn on Io, but that is not the case. It looks like Io is the one that's going to kick Bayley to the curb. During the match, there was a spot where Io accidentally hit Bayley, and it looked like she did not give a damn. I was so happy to see this. At this stage of the game, I thought that Damage Control needed a shakeup. I really did. There needed to be a new dynamic. And with Kyrie Sane coming in here, it looks like Damage Control as we know it may be over. When Kyrie was rumored to return, I thought she would return as a babyface and drive a wedge between Bayley and Io. But it turns out she's a heel, and now Bayley might be the one that turns babyface, not Io. There's so many ways this could go, so many avenues you could take. This may actually be very compelling. So now you have Io and Kyrie as heels, and Bayley wondering what the hell is going on with Io. In a way, Bayley almost becomes the main character of this story. Does she try to fit in with Io and Kyrie? Do they kick her out completely? Does she turn and try to seek the aid of Bianca and Charlotte? How the hell would that go, considering all the shit Bayley has done over the last 2 years? Something to keep in mind. Remember, Kyrie is no friend of Bayley whatsoever. The last time we saw Kyrie in the WWE, Bayley was kicking her ass. Bayley basically jumped Kyrie out of the WWE. And from the way Io is acting, I wouldn't be surprised if she was no friend of Bayley at this point. This is all leading to War Games. I believe we will have a SmackDown Women's Division War Games match. They'll have a week or two to fill out these teams. One name to look out for is Asuka. There are rumors that Asuka will ultimately be joining Kyrie and Io, which could lead to a JWO, Joshi World Order. I don't know, but that's something to keep your eye out for. If Triple H is starting a heel faction with Io, Kyrie, and Asuka, I have a hard time believing that this thing won't run all the way to Mania. And if that's the case, will Io still be champion? We could have some really good storytelling here. With Roman Reigns being a part-timer and Logan Paul having the US Championship, there's an opportunity to make the women's division more of a priority on SmackDown. I won't hold my breath, but it's possible they could do that. The SmackDown women's division is stacked, and if we're doing a War Games match with these ladies, there's no reason why that match can't be one of the better in-ring storytelling matches of the year. I'm excited to see how this story will play out from War Games into the Rumble season. Where does that leave Dakota Kai? So many questions here. Could Bayley be the one to dethrone Io? This is probably the most exciting thing to come out of Crown Jewel, and I can't wait to see what happens. What are your thoughts, guys? How do you feel about Kairi's return? What do you want to happen? What do you think will happen? What will be her first match? Let me know. Remember to like, comment, and subscribe, and I will talk to you later.
Keep up!